Hi, I'm Gidon from thetechnologyman.com. The Anker Soundcore Motion Boom is a 30-watt portable speaker with enough volume for use outdoors, up to 24 hours of battery life, and an IPX7 waterproof rating. It costs around $90 or £90, a third of the price of the JBL Xtreme 3 I'll be comparing it to in a sound test, together with several other speakers. How does it sound, and does it have all the features you need? Let's find out. Inside the box, get the speaker itself, an Anker branded USB-C charging cable, and a quick start guide. Picking up the speaker by its large carry handle, I was expecting it to be a lot heavier than it is. It weighs 1546 grams, only 500 grams heavier than its significantly smaller Motion Plus sibling, and lighter than the JBL Xtreme 3 and budget WKing D8. It's similar in size to the JBL and WKing, although the carry handle make it a fair bit taller. It measures 300mm by 115mm and is 170mm tall. The build quality is okay, but doesn't feel particularly rugged despite its IPX7 waterproof rating. The casing is made from a slightly mottled hard black plastic with a metal grille covering the mid-range drivers. The sides of the speaker have two unprotected Soundcore branded passive radiators. Around the back is a rubber flap revealing the USB-C charging port and a standard USB-A port to charge your gadgets. There's no 3.5mm audio in port, so you can only use the speaker wirelessly. This is something all the speakers I'm comparing it to have, so it's an odd omission. The top of the speaker has the partially rubberized carry handle and rubberized buttons to control the speaker. There's no NFC sensor like on the WKing. The bottom of the speaker has two rubber feet. The sizable 10,000mAh battery takes up to 4 hours to charge at up to 2.1 amps via its USB-C port, and supports both single and double-ended USB-C charging cables. The power button lights a steady red when charging and turns white when fully charged. The button flashes red when the battery is low. There's no way to see the current battery level without using your phone, which is disappointing. The USB-A charging port only has a 1 amp or 5 watt output, which I confirmed with a USB load tester. That's not enough to charge a tablet. I would have liked to have seen at least 2 amps of output that even the WKing has. But it'll still charge an iPhone in around 3 hours up to 3 times. The speaker has to be turned on for this to work, but it will work even if the speaker is being charged at the same time. This charging port only works when the battery has over 20% of charge remaining. Press the power button to turn on the speaker and initiate Bluetooth pairing. The Bluetooth button flashes. Tap on Soundcore Motion Boom in your Bluetooth settings. The Bluetooth light goes steady. You can disable all the accompanying sound prompts in the Soundcore app. Unlike the Motion Plus, you can only pair to one device at a time, which is inconvenient. To switch to another device, press the Bluetooth button. The LED will again flash and you can again tap on the speaker in Bluetooth settings. I hope they might improve this functionality via a firmware update. To reset the speaker and clear any paired devices, with the speaker on, press and hold the Bluetooth and volume up buttons for around 5 seconds until all the buttons light up. Then turn it back on. If you have two Motion Boom speakers, you can set them up as a stereo pair. Press the TWS buttons on both speakers and wait until both their buttons stop flashing. A 2 second press of the TWS button exits this mode. I only have one speaker, so can't test this, but I would have liked to have seen a party mode feature to connect multiple speakers in Soundcore's range, like the Motion Plus. JBL, LG, and many other manufacturers support this feature on many of their speakers. The Soundcore button has multiple functions which I'm never hugely keen on. A single press will play or pause your music or answer or end a phone call. A double press will play the next track, a triple press the previous track, and a 2 second press will activate your voice assistant. There's plenty of space to have separate buttons for at least some of these functions, especially since there's a TWS button that most people will never use. At least there's a separate Bluetooth pairing button. There's also the bass boost, bass up button, which is on and lit by default. The two 15-watt 2.5-inch full-range woofers with titanium diaphragms together with the passive radiators deliver a pleasing sound for a lot of the music I listen to. The Motion Boom is missing the tweeters of the smaller Motion Plus, but still has a good range and a well-rounded sound. Despite its name, it's not massively boomy, even with the bass up turned on, which offers a noticeable but subtle boost to the lower frequencies. I mostly left this default setting on when playing music, since it doesn't overpower the midtones and treble, which maintain their clarity. And there's impressively little distortion even at high volumes. I preferred its sound over the Motion Plus at higher volumes, where the smaller speaker can sound quite harsh. Using a sound level meter, 1 meter from the speaker grill, I measured the Motion Boom at maximum and 75% volume. You can see how it compares to the other speakers in the test, each tested in their loudest mode. The W King had outdoor mode turned on, the Soundcore speakers were a little louder with bass up off. It's not quite as loud as a W King D8, but it'll fill a medium-sized room and, as advertised, makes a decent outdoor speaker. Indoors, it's uncomfortably loud at maximum volume if you're within a couple of meters of it. Using the Soundcore app, which is getting more and more slick with each update, you can easily adjust EQ settings which are remembered on the unit itself. The interface is much clearer with the Motion Boom compared to the Motion Plus. There aren't loads of EQ presets, but you can hear the difference between them and you can see how they affect the frequency curve with the extra bass on and off, or you can create your own custom presets configured to your particular tastes. The app also lets you turn off the audio prompts, adjust the auto power off from the default 30 minutes and update the firmware. You can hear for yourself how the speaker sounds with bass up on and off and compared to the JBL Xtreme 3, W King D8, Minirig 3, Soundcore Motion Plus and the LG PL7. Let me know down below in the comments which is your favourite. I also have full reviews of some of these speakers playing various tracks, so take a look at the links below or the on-screen cards if you're interested. I've recorded the sound test with binaural microphones that capture stereo sound to try and provide the closest representation of what I'm hearing. Please listen with headphones for the best experience. Use the video chapters in the timeline or the timestamps below to skip ahead if you like. All the speakers sound pretty good. The Motion Boom actually sounds better to my ear than the far more expensive JBL Xtreme 3. Not just with this track, but with lots of music I listen to. But the JBL does have the typically bright JBL sound, and is a little louder than the Soundcore. The Minirig 3 speaker deserves a mention. With only a single driver, it doesn't have the soundstage of the other speakers, but it's impressive just how good it sounds for such a small speaker, and how loud it is. I hope to have a full review of this speaker soon. There was barely any audio delay watching YouTube on iOS, which is a welcome improvement over the Motion Plus.
The built-in microphone is good enough for phone calls and improves the closer you get to the speaker.
The Motion Boom uses Bluetooth 5.0 and the connection was reliable and the range was good, reaching the far end of the next room of my house over 10 meters away. But there's no support for any high quality Bluetooth codecs like aptX that the Motion Plus supports or even AAC. And with no 3.5mm output, there's no option for a wired connection for better sound quality. But with most of the portable speakers I've tested around this price point, it's difficult to hear any differences between these high quality codecs and SBC anyway. Battery life is quoted at an impressive 24 hours, but there's no detail specifying what volume this is at and whether bass up is enabled. But playing it between 60 to 80% volume with bass up on, I got at least a full day's usage. The Anker Soundcore Motion Boom sounds very good for the price, and the supporting Soundcore app makes it easy to adjust EQ to your tastes, and it's pretty loud too, with plenty of battery life. but it is a fairly large speaker, and although the carry handle is useful for moving it around with one hand, it's not altogether necessary considering it's relatively lightweight and it does make it more bulky. And although the build quality is fine, it feels less premium than all the other speakers I compared it against, except the WKing D8. And I really would expect a speaker like this to support at least two simultaneous Bluetooth connections. But it does have an IPX7 waterproof rating, and it can charge your phone with its hefty 10,000 mAh battery. If you don't need something quite as loud and have a little more to spend, consider the far more portable Soundcore Motion Plus. If you have even more money to spend and want a loud and very portable speaker, look no further than the Minirig 3. And if you want even louder at a similar price, take a look at the WKing D8. But the Soundcore Motion Boom is a little more refined. But I'd love to know what you think. How do you think the Motion Boom compares to the other speakers in the sound test? Let me know down below. And as always, if you have any questions, please ask. I read every comment and will do my best to respond. I do hope you found this video useful. Please like the video if you did. I'm releasing videos every week on the latest technology and how to get the most out of it. So please make sure you subscribe. It helps more than you think. And don't forget to tap the bell icon if you want to get notified as soon as a new video gets uploaded. Thanks for watching.